Let me get your attention, people. Right now, it's time to turn the volume on your radios up. Reason being, it's time for all new episode of Straight From The Heart, featuring yours truly, talking about myself, Kevin Hart. I'm not by myself. I'm with my crew. I'm talking about the Plastic Cup Boyz.
Yeah, that's me. That's me.
I'm in these streets. All right. These tweets.
Okay, that is enough.
Yes, let me talk.
Ladies and gentlemen, an all new episode starts now.
Now.
Hey, Mr. DJ, why don't you slow this party down?
Oh, shit.
Slow this party down. The ladies in here are flying.
Oh, shit.
Fly as hell. I see y'all in the comments.
And there's one who's caught my eye.
Yeah,
one who's caught my, I'm gonna pull her close to me.
Yeah, he talking about you, Ashley. We see you in the comments, Ashley.
And whisper sweet things in her ear. Oh, yeah.
I was supposed to be my part.
I'm gonna tell you why I'm so fucked up. Cam not even trying to stop this nigga. He letting it go.
No, like, he let it go. I'm saying like,
yeah, I stole it.
Oh,
this is a tribute to, you know,
stole it.
You started to go.
Yeah. No. It's a good thing. I love to share the limelight. Just know you're a part of something good.
Listen,
you know what I mean?
I don't know if you guys saw Harry and Joey's face, but I did.
Nah, they were stuck.
And let me tell you something. Joey progressively got closer to the camera, and his face, Joey's face said, "Naeem, what the fuck is you doing?" But then Naeem, he came in with harmony. Naeem actually didn't sound bad, and I think that's what upset Harry.
Now, this is what you failed to realize. He's saying R. Kelly.
That's right.
Oh, shit.
I sure
think
did.
About really, it. You think about it.
I sure
oh,
did.
Shit.
Just think about it. In the climate of the world today.
Leave that man alone.
No.
Five part harmony.
Hey, man, we're not this little black man.
AKA Naeem Epstein.
Mm. Oh, come on, Harry. Jesus Christ. Welcome, world. Welcome to an all new episode of Straight From The Heart right here on Sirius XM channel 96.
96.
This is Laugh Out Loud Radio, guys.
And all your shit, nigga.
This is Laugh Out Loud.
Everybody
radio.
Want to be a part of a good thing.
Where we do our best to give you real, raw, authentic radio on the fucking regular.
Conversation without a condom.
There you go. By regular, I mean every Tuesday and Thursday, and it will not be any different this week. Guys, I'm fucking pumped. You know, we're doing another live Zoom. Live Zoom means that, yes, we're live, but at the same time, we're on a Zoom, and the Zoom is available for thousands of people to actually sit and watch us.
Well, it ain't thousands of people in there. It's only 500.
Oh, it's 500? Well, 580. Well, then that means it's going to go up, Wayne. We just started the show. Okay.
You got 70 million followers. That's all you can draw up is 500.
First of all, I don't have 70 million followers. I have 92 million followers. Mm. And that's just on IG. I have a total of 164 million people.
Hey, I'm not talking about the 20 million you paid for.
What?
I'm not talking about the 20 million you paid for.
What are you talking about? Who pays for followers? Where do you get this stuff? It's blasphemy.
Where can I do that at? I need some.
First of all, Wayne, this is a time where we need to be kings, black kings standing together in unity.
So
we don't
give us a blast so we get some followers then if that's the case.
Power to the people.
I got a hot 15.
I see your shirt. I see your shirt,
Power to the people, brother.
Power to the goddamn people, man. Ladies and gentlemen, I would love to start the show, but you know I can't start because I'm never here by myself. I'm the host. I'm Kevin Hart, but I'm always with my brothers.
Welcome
my
back.
My brethren. Talk about the Plastic Cup Boyz. We're going to go from my right to my left. We got my man, Naeem Lynn, a.k.a.
Naeem the Star.
A.k.a.
Quarantine Eam.
A.k.a.
My shades look fly.
A.k.a.
Naeem the Lady's Dream. Oh, he's such a hunk.
Get in there, Nah. That's what I'm talking about.
One more.
A.k.a.
Black Power.
Black Power.
Black Power.
I like it. We gonna keep it going. We got my man Spank Horton, a.k.a.
One of El Chapo's goons.
A.k.a.
Smooth Thug with the good hair.
A.k.a.
Sweet Dick Willie from Philly.
A.k.a.
Oh, shit. He just fucked.
AKA Curvy.
I was about to say. This nigga just fucked up.
AKA COVID.
Everybody.
Shout out to goddamn Corona.
Oh, no. Niggas started giggling and then I'm laughing and shit.
But right? How you get the coughs after Sweet Dick Willie from Philly?
Because I'm eating too. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, Jesus Christ. Let's keep it going. We got my man Harry Ratchford, AKA.
Harry Goodspeed.
AKA.
Quarter Water.
AKA
the Mayor of Gaffney,
AKA
Mr. Turndown Service,
AKA
Convertible Burt,
AKA
One Love.
Oh, Jesus Christ, he stuttered too. he stuttered too.
What's this excuse?
Hey, I don't know, man. He's stuttered.
Come on, I'm trying to finish.
AKA
Bucket Low Like Fucking
Fuck it, dog. No.
And all the hoes got to know my name.
Ooh. He trying to get you back now. Nah. He trying to riff like you now.
Eddie Kane Jr.
You want my spot flash?
Eddie Kane Jr. Here, baby.
You can't get it because you ain't got it.
Harry. Who are these hoes you speak of?
Oh, you know it's Tiffany.
Hey, we going to keep it going, man. We got my man, Wayne Brown. Let's see if we get lucky today. AKA?
Dead size.
Nah, we almost had it. Almost had it. Hey, Wayne, how you doing, buddy?
Great. What's up with you?
Nothing. Just checking on you. Thought we may get lucky and get an AKA. The people loved it.
Bro, keep it moving, bro. Ain't no need in having a conversation with
you. You sure? Because the people loved it when Wayne gave an AKA.
That's not going to hype Wayne.
He only did that while you wasn't here. We have fun when you ain't
I like
here.
Everybody else's introduction when they do it. I don't like when you do it.
Okay, watch this. Watch this right here. AKA
trash. Still trash.
That's pretty fucking Wayne. Funny.
Move on, okay. Bro. All right. Just checking, Wayne. Just checking, buddy. We're gonna keep it going. We got my man Joey Wells, aka
50+2.
AKA.
I'm on the other side.
AKA.
I said what I said.
AKA.
Don't get slapped.
AKA.
CJ.
Give it up for the millennials.
AKA.
Black and I'm proud.
Nice. AKA,
CJ's back.
Let's get this motherfucker started.
There you go. We got to get it started. You know what, guys? Before we start our show, man, I'm going to do something that I really do, that the people don't get to see me do. I want to take the time to applaud you guys and give you the flowers that you also deserve. I missed our last show. I missed our Thursday show. Because I went to Minneapolis, I went to the memorial for George Floyd, and you guys held it down, man. And from what I'm hearing, one of the better episodes. I heard you guys not only were funny, but you guys were on track with the conversation that we said that we should prioritize. You guys kept it going, man, and people seem to have loved it. So I just want to take the time to say good job, guys.
Hold
man.
Up. Somebody just said that shit was lame.
Oh, you read the comments.
Yeah.
Well, I was trying to give you flowers and do the opposite. I got a lot of those comments too, where people said y'all was ass. But I wanted to come in hot and say that I loved it, and I think you guys do a fucking amazing job, man. Thank you guys for holding it down.
The show was all the hook last week.
No, I'm serious. I heard that. I heard you guys fucking killed it. Dead ass.
While we were doing the show, we saw you on the news at the memorial.
Uh-huh.
And there was a Black Panther next to you.
Yeah.
You guys talking about Tyrese.
Yeah.
You guys talking about Tyrese.
I'm not talking about Chitaka.
No. You talking about y'all talking about Tyrese. Okay, look, I can give y'all the story. Look, okay, you know, I got no problem with give you guys some stories. You know, we all went down there, and by we all, Will Packer, who is a good friend of mine, man.
They all flew with you?
Yeah, we got Universal to give us a plane because we told them what we wanted to do. So Universal provided the plane for us to go. So it was Tyrese, myself, Regina Hall, Marseille, Shayla Cohen, who's another
Tiffany
exec.
Haddish was with y'all.
Yes, right? Tiffany Haddish was there. And T.I. met us, and Shaka was with T.I. Tyrese was with us. But we went down with like a good, it may have been just 12 of us, but you know, it was literally just not to get attention. It was to go and support. The lawyer that is representing George Floyd, Packer, knew him and just said, hey man, we just want to come extend our support to you, to the family, and let you guys know that you got other voices. So, you know, when I got on the plane, Tyrese, you know, Tyrese, he was in the back. He was just, he had on a white shirt, some jeans, just chilling. So I said, what up, Reese? He said, what up, Kev? And I said, all right, shit, good to see you, baby. It was early. You know, so I went to sleep. I took a nap because I had a long night. I woke up. Tyrese had on a black raincoat, black t-shirt, and a beret.
And gloves.
And gloves. Love gloves. Yeah, without the fingertips. And Reese told me, he said, what's up, black man? I said, oh, oh, shit. Oh, it's about to go down. I said, it's about to go down.
Yeah, I'm about to pop this perk. Y'all ready?
Hey, no, come on, Spank. Stop it.
What?
Listen, but we went there, man. We went there. And I, you know what I want to say, man? What I really want to bring attention to? Al Sharpton, I've never heard Al Sharpton actually preach. Have you?
The
have
rat.
Any of you, have any of you guys? Have it, first of all, Spank, we... are not
informant.
In a time, first
he's
of
a
all,
rat. He's a
let me stop you both. We are not in a time to destroy our own.
I'm not destroying. Let's talk about Tyrese.
I didn't talk about Tyrese. I gave him fine. I said he woke up. He had a black raincoat on. Return. I didn't talk about him bad.
Who's destroying him? It's the known
I'm just
fact.
Saying, I know that, but we are right now all about uplifting our own. Well, I'm asking.
A rat can uplift us?
I'm asking, have any of y'all ever heard Al Sharpton preach before?
No,
have any of you guys ever heard it?
Heard a little.
No,
bit.
No,
never. Joey
heard a little.
Never bit. Wanted to.
Yeah, nobody.
I'm not saying
to.
Whether you wanted
never
to or
wanted
not.
To.
I think he asked me had with. I think no. He spoke at Michael Jackson's funeral. I heard him speak a couple times.
Well, you wasn't there neither.
I can say, man. I heard Al Sharpton preach. This is the first time he acted as the headlining preacher at the memorial. Al, he got down, man. Al Sharpton. Got down. I'm talking message. I'm talking passion. I'm talking the way that he mixed the Bible in with the now and threw some street gander and cadences in there. He really was good. I've never personally witnessed.
I don't know what gander means.
You know what's crazy?
Street gander. What is that?
I don't know. I thought you would know.
No, you know, this is the honest question, Kev. You said he mixed the Bible with the street.
I think though, they just threw the word in there, man.
Gander.
Like something used the word or something.
Gander.
No, I thought this was.
Is.
I thought Spank. I thought you would know.
You Wayne, know, you know what gander is. Wayne,
gander.
I know what gander. You meant.
I know. I've been done with Al Sharpton since that mirror selfie, brother.
Yeah, that mirror selfie.
Come on.
Can't
Wayne.
Look at him the same way.
Whatever he said after that is irrelevant, bro.
Come on,
and,
Wayne.
And he said he shout out Tiffany Haddish during the speech. I said,
he did it. He did it.
Oh, you did?
He didn't. No, man. The social media took that and ran with it. He said what he said was at the end of it, he asked for silence for the 8 minutes. And I believe is it 38 seconds, guys? I don't want to mess the time.
46,
period
I think. 8 minutes, 46 seconds, I think.
The time period that George Floyd was on the ground and that he was being basically, you know, choked out, basically. He said, I want you guys to feel that pain. So he asked for silence. So after it was over, everybody, he said a prayer. And he said, before we go, I just want to thank some people that didn't, you know, come to be thanked, but I just want to acknowledge them for coming. And he started going down the names. And when he got to Tiffany Haddish,
Wayne showing a picture of Al Sharpton's selfie
Wayne.
In the mirror.
Wayne, take the
Zoom.
On
the Zoom video, he's showing.
He took
Wayne,
what
come
made
on,
that
man.
Nigga do that? He was in workout gear and everything.
That's when he lost weight, man. He's wild as so.
Speaking of that, it's crazy how he lost all that weight and still got a fat voice.
What? Come on, man.
Fat person voice. How do fat people sound?
Like Al Sharpton.
come on, man.
You know when what's the nigga that said jam tonight?
Like they all got asthma, like they wheezing all the time.
Harry, what's the nigga? Oh, Freddie Jackson. When Freddie Jackson lost weight, his voice sound different. Al Sharpton kept the fat boys.
He's Either way, I don't want people to think Tiffany asked for a shout out. She didn't ask for a shout out. He was going.
No, they didn't say she asked for it. They said he gave her a shout out.
No, he was just going down, just thanking people, and yeah, it wasn't really. It wasn't like yo, I want to shout out such and such.
Yeah, well, I give acknowledgement. It's the same shit.
Right, well, look, I don't know what you're saying. Okay, look, I'm not gonna do
shout out. Kev tried to defend some shit. He really don't want to defend.
I'm not gonna fucking do that.
Kevin Hart is here.
No, but you heard what he said. He said that Kevin didn't want to be acknowledged, but I'm acknowledging him anyway. He was trying to acknowledge me early on. I was like, no, I'm good. I'm just going to sit over here in the corner.
You, nigga, you weren't in the corner, first of all. And the camera was on you more than on the body.
We was on the right. We was on the right hand side.
Yo, did you have a mask on?
Camera was on you the whole time.
I didn't even know.
Kev, did you have a mask on?
I did not. I did not have a mask on. No, I did not.
Somebody hit me. They was like, it's like, tell your boy wear a mask.
You know what I said? I said, if everybody else got a mask on, what I need a mask for?
That's super logic right there.
What I need mask for? If everybody else there got a mask on, then I should be good. Because the mask is doing what?
No, that's ignorant.
It's protecting. The mask is protecting the person from putting it out. So I said, okay. But I honestly, I had it in my back pocket. So it wasn't like I didn't have one. But,
oh, you had it like a Gucci bandana.
No, I just had a regular mask in my back pocket, but I was like, I'm sitting down. It's not like I'm gonna be talking to nobody, so we were just sitting down. I didn't, dude. Naeem said it, and Naeem was he was right. That fucking mask, man, your breath, when you get to smelling your own shit after a while, it's not cool. That mask is not a good look for me. I didn't like what I was smelling.
That mask helped made people brush their tongue. That's what they made the people do.
Maybe or I just stop wearing the mask.
Yeah. Or just give up. Or just give up like I did.
I ain't brushing my teeth extra.
Hey, if y'all still need a mask, I got a few of these. Boy sent me a bunch of them. If y'all need a mask,
that look like
boy
sent me.
Yeah. No, it's not.
That shit ain't gonna protect against
like some stripper panties.
No, I got the slip for the filter and all.
Like a thong,
yeah, bro.
That's a song.
Put your drawers back.
Put your knee shit back in the drawer, bro.
Oh, come on.
Over there missing his wife.
Come on, guys.
Over there trying to smell him while I'm walking around.
Feed on my face, yeah. Ain't nothing.
Come on, Spank. hey, guys, before we start moving, I think we should shout out, man. I want to shout out the governors and the mayors right now that you see being active and trying to get certain bills and laws implemented into the system that basically show that they're being serious about, you know, the change or the attempt to provide or make change. Mainly, I gotta say, the governor from New York, man, he's been really vocal. He's been adamant about Cuomo. Being in front of it.
Andrew Cuomo.
Yeah, Cuomo. He's been real loud about saying the things that he wants to do and wants to get done. Right now, they're trying to do a law not just that one. The one where using race.
The Karen law.
Yes. What are they calling it? Wait, that's what it should be called.
It's Amy something, whoever the
chief. Amy Cooper, I think it was her name.
Yes, but people that are using the false claims and attaching race to it in calling the police. You know, for example, for our listeners and for the people that are on our live Zoom, you know, people are like, hey, there's a black man and he's threatening me and there's nothing happening. And there's video to show that, well, that's going to be a charge. That's going to be an offense.
Did y'all see the latest one? A guy that usually be like jogging and working out and be dancing, and the lady called a cop on him and they locked him up and all that.
It was in Alameda. It's in Alameda.
Yeah, right out. Yeah, Alameda.
Dog, I seen a page on Instagram yesterday called Karen's Going Wild.
Yeah, I just followed that.
Yeah, I saw that. That's hilarious.
Karen Going Wild.
Karen's
getting
going
the
wild.
Ass whooped too.
You see that one in that gas station the other day in a striped shirt? I mean, dress.
Slap her. Slap that lady. Lady grabbed the face. Said, "Oh, oh!"
Got right about it.
Grabbed the face. Left. Do you think that the videos though that are servicing? Do you think that these videos
circulating?
Circulating.
Surfacing was good.
Surfacing was cool. I don't know.
Did What's you say service thing? Or surface?
Surface. Surfacing.
Oh, I thought
surfacing.
You said surface.
Surface. He said surfacing. Surface.
No, surfacing. My bad. But these videos that are now surfacing and you see them circulating around, my question is, do you think that this is shining a light bulb in making these white individuals that possibly have played a part and these see how wrong they are? Do you think, like, after seeing it and being able to watch it live, do you think you go, oh, fuck, I really am out of pocket and out of place?
All they saying is you ain't seen the beginning.
Them old white bitches ain't on social media looking at this shit.
Yeah, somebody will send it to them. Their grandkids send this shit to them.
Yeah, you got no choice but to see it because people's jobs are being taken away. You know, people are getting in trouble with the law like this. So you got to know what it's for and what it's about. My question is, it's like if we all are out and we're arguing and we get drunk while we argue and somebody got us on tape, and then when you sober, you see that, you're able to go, damn, I was tripping.
You see the difference with that one? We was drunk.
Drunk. I'm just using that.
Some of these white people are just clearly out of their mind. They're never going to see it. They don't get it.
Those people that's calling in are assholes, and they've always been an asshole. They've been an asshole since they were like in junior high. So this just, you know, a continuation of being an asshole when they get older, just to do shit like that. Like everybody in that neighborhood in Alameda was yelling to the cops, stop. Hey, we've seen him before. He's okay. It was that one person called. So that tells you that's the one person in that neighborhood. She's an asshole. Because everybody else is like, we see him. He danced. There's no problem. And right. That one person, that bothers that person.
Okay. But the cops approached him, why don't they just ask him, hey, what's going on? What are you doing? They see that he's fine. They keep it moving. What are you locking him up for?
Can you break it down, Spank, just for our listeners that may not know or be aware? Can you paint the picture a little better for them of this particular incident that you're referring to?
All right. It was a black guy that lives in the neighborhood. I don't think he lived on that block, but he lives in the neighborhood. And he's always, like, every day he's jogging and, like, working out or during the streets. He'd be dancing and all types of stuff, just working out. And lady called the cop, says a black guy out here, African-American, it's an African-American male. He's running around. I don't know what he's doing. He just, maybe he's a little mental or maybe he's on drugs. I don't know. And the cop came. Go ahead. What'd you say now?
I got a question for y'all. So it's okay that he's dancing, but what if that nigga was crip walking?
What's wrong with you, man?
What's wrong? What's your problem? What is Naeem's problem?
It might be concerned. Them niggas like,
oh, Jesus Christ, Naeem.
They got their crip walking and shit. Nah. Hey, man.
But my thing is, the cops should have just approached him, not grabbing him and all that. Should have just approached him and talked to him. Hey, what's going on, Shanae? What are you doing?
Naeem is stupid.
Naeem said, hey, man. What's... hey.
Jesus Christ.
Hey, but Spank, that's all. Alameda is also a city that has had problems with the police. That is a city that,
yeah, you know, yeah, I heard.
They tell, you know, when you, it's right on the other side of Oakland. So mm-hmm. They tell you like, hey man, them, they be tripping over there on black people. So
here's another question. Here's another question that I ask. Now that the videos once again are surfacing and they're circulating around, do you think that there should be a better understanding of the definition of white privilege than what it seems to be interpreted as now?
No,
they feel like they worked hard, bro.
That's the definition of white privilege. That's the definition of white privilege.
It is, but they're not going to understand it.
Yeah, I think,
but you know what?
A white person is not going to understand that they're privileged. They're not going to understand it because they're.
Well, I wouldn't say they're not going to understand it. That's not true.
I'm saying if you benefit off white privilege, it's a harder view of yourself to take. You know what I mean? To say you are, no matter how hard you work or whatever, you'll have that one step up on a black person who has to work twice as hard, three times as hard to get the same stuff. I'm just saying white privilege is something that people, they won't see. I don't feel like they would see it.
I think the younger generation, some of them are seeing it. I really feel that way. I feel some of them are seeing it, like they're looking and they're going, what is white privilege? Some of them are asking, and we're saying like, here it is. And they're like, oh shit. We're benefiting off of just being who we are. Other people are struggling because of who they are. It's just their skin color. I really believe that, because as I'm listening to some of these young white people talk, I just think some of them are getting it, where there's a generation who, like, well, I worked really hard for this.
I'm talking about that generation.
Well, that would be like my generation.
The TV is littered with apologies of people not knowing what they're saying and understanding how the impact of what they're saying.
Wayne, give me your definition of white privilege, Wayne. What's your definition of white privilege?
I mean, I don't feel like it's a clear cut definition, but it's just like they're benefiting from the race that they are based on history, based on their ancestors and what's been passed down to them, whether it's rights, whether it's jobs or, you know, financial situation or living circumstance or whatever that is, you're in a position to benefit from your past and your history, which is now being passed down. I don't think if you're that person, you don't see that, but it's not like you can be like, yo, fuck this. Let me throw this white.
I don't want it. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't want this shit no more. I want to be like everybody else.
I feel like initially they're not going, let's just say before this time, you know, where everybody's awareness is kind of high, is very high right now. I'm saying in the past, that privilege, when people said that, I feel like the people who were benefiting off the white privilege, it kind of fell on deaf ears, because you, like Wayne is saying, like you're not giving it up. It's just like, this is, I work hard. This is what I get. And that's just it. Not knowing that a black man or a person of color has to work 2 and 3 times harder, or the opportunities are just not there. There's many hardworking white people. I mean, hardworking white people. So I don't want to discredit that. I'm just saying,
if they go on
the interview, you don't understand the benefit. Right. You don't understand the benefit that you're getting in that moment.
Let me, just to kind of cap off what Harry and Wayne are saying, this is what I wrote on social media today. I said, dear white people, the term white privilege doesn't mean you didn't work hard to get what you have. It means there's a strong possibility that as hard as you may have worked, it still may be even harder for a black person to achieve that same success.
Mm.
Yeah, so, I mean, that's
a good,
that's what they were saying, but there's more eloquence to it, because they, you know, I wrote it down. So
I think that I wish that there was an easier way to say it. I think that there's some simplicity in what it is, right? Like there should be an understanding of what it means. And it just means that out the gate, your start is so much better than a black person. Out the gate, as a white man or woman, your start is so much better than ours. And because of that, there's a privilege that comes with that.
Right. But you as their start, they feel like you could have started the same way.
Yeah, but that's the part where I think
our was locked up. They don't understand they threw drugs in our neighborhoods. You know what I'm saying? Like, they don't understand all that. They just look at it as, we both was born as kids. I had both my parents, your daddy just left your mother. You know what I'm saying? Well,
that's some white people that grew up that were not privileged, those are the ones that really don't understand. Because there's exceptions to the rule. Every white person, there's some white people that grew up in the trailer, you know, and that's their grandparents' fault for abusing their white privilege years ago.
Fucked it up.
But there's some of them that grew up in the trailer. They didn't have much, and they were like, yo, I made it out of nothing. So,
but they still got an advantage when they go into that interview.
I know that. I'm agreeing with you. I'm saying this is why they think that.
That's why
they have that mentality of, I work my ass off too. I don't have white privilege.
Well, here's the thing, though. Here's the scary thing. Slavery is over, but the concept that comes with slavery. Well, listen, slavery is over, but the concept that comes with slavery is not. We are positioned to be in last place. Mm-hmm. We're positioned to always be at the bottom. Mm-hmm. So if you look at the things that black people have to deal with, it's the climb to what we consider to be the top. So what is crazy when you look at this thing in life, in the world, is the opportunity of the opportunity within success is such a far fucking reach for us. We like coming out of where we come from, when you talk about debt, when you talk about lack of credit, when you talk about financial literacy, when you talk about having the know-how to move forward, it's not given to us. And the reason why is because there's a certain expectation of fucking they don't need it because they're fine there, right? And it's been that way. So as we go and we fight and we climb and we try to achieve, well, they look at it as, well, we can have 5 or 8 or 10, but then we'll stop it there. there's not opportunities for us to create the true wealth that we fucking really need or would want. Like,